Okay, so today is Friday the 13th of August, and I'm here to clean Mr. and Mrs. Moon's headstone. Robert R., born 1907 to 1969. You were rather young. And Myrtle C., 1906 to 1974, you were also rather young. I hope you both had good lives, Mr. and Mrs. Moon, and I hope you did not fear your death. And I hope you are not only resting in eternal peace, I hope you are enjoying the benefits of heaven that only angels can know. With that, I'm going to get started on cleaning your headstone. I already see a lot of spiders' eggs in here. Oh, Lord. That's going to be fun. It's super hot here in Central Florida. My car said it was 95, but I think they say the heat index is like 110 or something. So what I do whenever I come to the cemetery is I just drive and look. And as soon as I find a headstone that looks like it needs cleaning, I stop, get all my stuff out, and get to work. Like cleaning spiders' eggs. Oh gosh. Ugh. But they shouldn't be in here. Right? Mr. and Mrs. Moon, I would love to hear from you. Anything you have to share or say. I know you don't know me. Okay. I'd love to hear. Oh my gosh, I just have to get past these spiders. This is really, oh gosh, these are eggs. Oh my gosh. Oh gosh. Y'all did have good lives. You both died kind of young, so something must have happened. I'm looking forward to getting back on track, coming out here on a regular basis. Life has been rather chaotic for me for, oh, I don't know, 15 years, 20 years, as old as my daughters are, that's how long it's been chaotic. But it's getting even more chaotic. Looking forward to some peace in my life. I've been all alone today. I could have gone anywhere that I wanted. And I chose to come to the cemetery, as I always do, because it is where I find peace. Yesterday, as a matter of fact, I brought my dog here to the cemetery for the first time after his vet appointment, and I took him for a walk. And he did so good here. He's crazy, my dog. He's just crazy, but he did so good. So I think I may bring him back. And he learned right off the bat when he got here that you cannot pee on headstones. No, no, and no. Good boy. without getting into too much detail, well, I have bipolar, and so I'm used to being blamed for most everything in life, even when it's not caused by me. And I'm going through one of those moments right now. And so when I know I'm well, I just don't understand. Like, how can anybody be mad at me? Usually I'm mad at myself. But it is what it is. So as my mom always says to me, onward and upward, soldier. Sorry, spider, I just had to end it right there. That's just, we're being tortured at this point. Anyway, coming to the cemetery has been my way of finding, gross, spider, of finding my balance and knowing that I am well. And I am well. No doubt. So, I just have to remember that and keep moving forward. Hears the word bipolar, and it's like immediately there's like one of three words they think of: crazy, lunatic, and crazy. And that's not always the case. Bipolar people, we're normal people too. It's just we respond to life in far more sensitive ways. So where somebody may say, oh, look at that moon, somebody with bipolar may say, look at that glorious, beautiful, shining ball of life in the sky, you know? Like, that's what bipolar is. And then, yes, when there's problems, we respond with vulgarities at times, curse words, and that's what I've tried to explain to my family for all these years. We can learn to live with bipolar and cope with it, but we can't always control our bipolar. I'm 48 years old now. I wasn't diagnosed with bipolar until I was 37 or something. So prior to my diagnosis, even myself was like, what is wrong with me? And then after my diagnosis and got onto medication, life was a totally different world. Much more beautiful world to live in. When your children are also bipolar, oh my, that's where the problem is. It's really hard to tell a young person, hey, I know this is what works. They're too young to understand, even with medication. On a different topic. When I was here yesterday with Manfred, my dog, there was nobody here, and he just kept stopping and looking and staring, like, ears up and everything, and I was like, come on, let's go, buddy. And so halfway into the walk, I realized, yes, he was probably seeing a spirit. Animals can sense spirit in much greater ways than humans. Which is why often you hear that if somebody's died and they had an animal, and whoever has that animal will say, oh my gosh, they won't stop looking at the window, or they won't stop looking up towards the stairs. It's because they see their loved one. No doubt. Not to mention that about 20 years, I think the statistics said 3% of the population in the world had bipolar. So that was something just not really talked about often with anybody. And now I think it's more like 20% or 15% of the population has bipolar. And why is that? Well, more doctors are informed and more people are being diagnosed, period. Oh my God, is there an ant on me? I know a lot of people also say, oh my God, don't even talk about bipolar. Oh my God, don't tell people you have it. Why? I am a normal person. It's not like I do cartwheels across the cemetery here while I'm cleaning headstones or bring out my karaoke machine and start singing here. I'm like totally normal. I just am super sensitive. That's it. Super sensitive to life, everything in it. And that's not always a bad thing, right? Mr. and Mrs. Moon, now that you've heard me say all that, you're probably like, oh Lord, who's this bipolar girl cleaning our heads down? Actually, just like my dog, who I believe saw spirit yesterday, animals are in tune with the energy of spirit. That's why I'm able to communicate with spirit, because I'm so in tune with energy, my own energy. Yesterday I was cleaning out in our garage just stuff, and we had an old armoire cabinet out there, and it just had junk in there, like wrapping paper and random stuff, name tags. So anyway, I started to take it all out, and apparently I found the motherlode of where the roaches live. And they jumped all over my face, into my boots, into my fanny pack. I was jumping up and down because I was scared, and I ended up stomping on several of them. That's how many there were. I couldn't believe it. But they're all gone now. I'm not a big believer in bug spray, but that called for bug spray. So now I got my garage space back to me again. Mr. and Mrs. Moon, I heard one of you say French fries. Not sure. I do hope you had a good life, both of you. Red ants still up my dress. Every time I lift my dress, they're not there, but I feel like I'm being eaten alive. Whew. Okay, I'm gonna get some water and see how far we come. Here's the water right here. Perfect. Goodness. Hey. There we go. Tell me what, I've never seen so many bugs here. Spiders and ants and wasps, bees. Okay, this is looking pretty good. Still, definitely some more scrubbing. Mr. and Mrs.
moon.
I do find it so peaceful coming out here. I mean, even just walking my dog. This is a very beautiful cemetery. And most of the time when I come here, there is nobody here other than the souls, me, and nature. Going back and forth myself with whether I want to be buried or cremated and buried. Of course, if I wanted to be buried, it would be here. When cleaning headstones, you have to do it all, not just the front. You have to do the back too. They've been talking about the hurricane. Is it Fred or something? It could be making its way up here in a few days. I definitely have a lot of water. I need to stock up on wine. I do get all of my brushes and stuff at the dollar store. Life changes all the time, like right before our eyes. Like I'm thinking about my daughter who's 18. Well, just 6 months ago, she was practically begging me to come with me to the cemetery to clean headstones, and now I don't even see her. She has a full-time job working at a pet boarding facility. Listening to all different music. And do the finishing touches. This all looks really good up front. is moon. I like to bring a chamois with me. So when I'm done, hose out of control. When I'm done, the chamois is really good. I do like to take before and after pictures, and I upload them to the app called Find a Grave. And of course, I want the pictures to look perfect. So it's better when I can dry them. Mrs. Moon, I'm going to get some flowers for you. Got some nice fall flowers. Thank you, Robert and Myrtle Moon, for your life. I hope it was a good life. And I do hope you are resting in eternal peace. Thank you for sharing in this moment with me.